My name is Laura Collier. I'm a resource management officer here in Terra Nova National Park. My role under the direction of the ecologist is to oversee the monitoring programs. I focus on logistics and implementation of monitoring, as well as supervising our technical staff and our monitoring students. In Terra Nova National Park, the boreal forest here is primarily made up of black spruce forest, but we also have about 20 or so percent of balsam fir forest. So you have different age classes within each of those species or compositions of forest, and typically a healthy forest will have representation of all of those different age classes. But over time, we've really come to recognize and understand how important fire is as a natural disturbance process to regenerating the forest. So it allows, you know, seeds to be released from cones, it allows those seeds to reach the forest floor and create that new cohort of trees to continue that process of regeneration. You know, we're bringing in fire as a management tool to help our forests regenerate, but it creates opportunities for other species to get in. So what that does is it shifts what the natural composition of the forest in the park here would be. If we took humans out of the equation and fire was a natural part of the disturbance regime in the boreal forest, you would see patches of forest across the landscape of different ages, of different stages of regeneration. But when you introduce fire management and fire suppression, the tendency is to have older growth forests more represented on the landscape, because essentially what you're doing is stopping these forests from going back to their sort of initial stage. So fire naturally allows for us to sort of hit the reset button on that forest and start back at the beginning and go through that process of regeneration. You know, if you kind of look around you, there's a lot of biomass on the forest floor, and a lot of the nutrients are actually locked up in the biomass that we see. So fire is that process that enables those nutrients to kind of become available in the soil. All of the plants that you see here in the boreal forest have evolved with fire. So by using fire as a tool across the landscape, it allows us to achieve ecological integrity of the ecosystem as a whole. You really have to balance having the right ecosystem type with reducing risks. So in this case, we're looking for mature or over-mature black spruce forest. We're looking for areas that have species that are fire adapted. So we know that they've evolved with fire. And so really that's this dominant black spruce forest type. Before you would do a prescribed fire, we would go out and assess, you know, how many cones do we have in the area? What's the soil type like? So you have all these sort of checks and balances to make sure that you have everything you need before you actually do the prescribed fire. So when we come back to assess success of that burn, we're looking at, of course, the amount of organic matter that's remaining. So we're hopeful that we're working towards having enough of that organic matter removed that the seeds can establish and grow. I love the dynamic nature of my job and where it brings me.